Hello. What is the relationship between DMT and melatonin? Now, I'm sure you know, but melatonin is the hormone that is produced when it gets dark or when we refrain from natural light. It is produced, it activates the parasympathetic, so you really calm down and you're able to fall asleep. So it's the hormone that we need to be able to fall asleep. Now, the melatonin is made in the pineal gland. So you have your spine, then your brain stem, and on top of there is a little gland called the pineal gland, pineal gland in English, glándula pineal in Spanish, and this is the gland that produces melatonin. It produces serotonin and it produces DMT. Now, what is the relationship between DMT and melatonin? And this is, I think this is mind-blowing, but it's very simple. Melatonin minus CO2 is DMT, right? So basically, if we produce enough melatonin and then we make sure that we lower the CO2 level, then automatically DMT would be produced. Now, this is interesting because we know from the research that has been done that if we breathe like for 1 minute intensely, so like, maybe it may make you dizzy. So 1 minute is like 15 of those breaths, something like that. Within 1 minute of deeper breathing, full in and fully out, we release more than 50% of the CO2 level in our bloodstream. Now, if there's a temporal imbalance in our bloodstream, CO2 is extremely low, then automatically our muscle, nerve tissue, and the brain is not a muscle, but let's say to make it simple, it's also a muscle. It will release CO2 to that blood that has lower CO2. And your melatonin should theoretically automatically be transformed into DMT. So this is pretty interesting, I feel. And then, the deep breathing and breathing CO2 out could already make from melatonin DMT just because you get the CO2 part out of the melatonin. And then after breathing, whatever, maybe 5 times, maybe 50 times, and you take a deep breath in and you squeeze your lower muscles. There's a lot of DMT in our spinal fluids. You push that DMT up as well. So this is purely theoretical and there's no real double clinical trial yet proving that. Although I feel it very much that this is true. From two sides, through deep breathing, breath hold, squeezing your lower muscles, pushing the blood to the head or the spinal fluids up, theoretically we should be able to produce DMT. Anyway, short video about melatonin and DMT. And in the description, I will post a PDF about DMT that you can download if you like. And also a link to where I got this knowledge from. Now, that's it for this video. If you like this, please give it a thumbs up. And if you want to subscribe to my channel, it's very much appreciated. Not only from me, but my 5 kids as well. And I'll see you in the next video. All right, bye-bye.